Hello friends, welcome back to ProHut IT Services. Good to see you back. In this video, we'll talk about an interview question related to DHCP reservation. In the last video, we followed step-by-step approach to configure DHCP reservation. Before we start, please ensure that you have good understanding of DHCP and DHCP reservation. If you are not sure, then click on the link shown on the screen. First link will explain about DHCP server. Second link explains about DHCP reservation. To start with, let's take a scenario. Let's assume that you have a DHCP server and few client machines. All these clients are supposed to receive dynamic IP address from DHCP server. If you have defined a scope from 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.200 on DHCP server, this means client machines will start receiving IP address from 192.168.1.100 onwards. Hope till now we both are on the same page. Now let me ask you an interview question. Can you reserve an IP address beyond the scope defined in DHCP server? I'll elaborate the question to ensure we both are on the same page. If you have defined the scope from 100 to 200, then can we reserve an IP address 192.168.1.90? You can pause the video for 2 minutes, think about the answer, and then type the same in comment section, and then resume the video. Okay, hope you must have typed the answer in comment section. Now it's my turn to give you the answer. So, the answer to the question is yes. We can reserve an IP address 192.168.1.90. Even if we have defined a DHCP scope from 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.200. This means that DHCP reservation is not dependent on scope. In DHCP reservation, you can define the IP that you want to reserve, either it is defined in the scope or not. Now let's do the practical together to understand it better. To start the practical, let's go to DHCP server now. We are on DHCP server now. By clicking on address pool, we can see that DHCP scope is defined from 192.168.1.00 to 192.168.1.200. Let's delete the reservation from last lab. Right click on reservations, click new reservation for new reservation to be created. Type reservation name. For this practical, we are defining client's name as reservation name, that is 1801. Type IP address that you want to reserve. Let's take IP address 90. Type MAC address of your client machine. Select appropriate supported types, that is DHCP, BOOTP or both. BootP is designed prior to DHCP. It is intended to configure diskless workstations with limited boot capabilities. BootP clients do not bind or renew configuration except when the system restarts. On the other hand, DHCP clients do not require a system restart to rebind or renew configuration with the DHCP server. Clients automatically enter a rebinding state at set timed intervals to renew their leased address allocation with the DHCP server. For this practical, let it be default and click on Add. In the address leases, we can verify if new lease is created or not. Now let's go to client machine to release and renew IP address. We are on client machine now. Type ipconfig /release to release an old IP address. Type ipconfig /renew to renew an IP address. Great, we can see that IP address 192.168.1.90 is assigned to this machine. This confirms that DHCP reservation is not dependent on DHCP scope. Let's go back to DHCP server. We are on DHCP server now. In the address leases, we can see that reservation is still inactive. Let's refresh the window. Good. Reservation is active now. Hope your concepts about DHCP reservation is clear now. Stay tuned for more interview questions. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Thanks for watching this video. Bye. Keep smiling and have fun.